Hello, hi, this is Shihan Sen. You can call me Who. Founder of the Archery Association of Tamil Nadu, director of the Who Archery Mission, and the certified level 3 coach from World Archery. You are in the level 2 archery coaches training and certification program, specialization compound archery. What you are doing, going to learn today here in this session is about the parts of a compound bow. We will discuss about compound bow risers. This class is based on syllabus prescribed by World Archery, the supreme body of archery in the world. No bow would be complete without a riser. The device does not only connect the upper limb and the lower limb together, it basically functions as the mother board of your bow. All your equipment is attached directly to the riser. Therefore, it's essential to buy a riser that allows you to attach all the equipment you want. Since there are so many different risers available in the market, it can be quite an ordeal and a daunting task. Therefore, we will discuss everything you want to know about a riser in great detail. A good riser is light, is comfortable to grip and hold, has a good balance, is stable, has good geometry, does not vibrate too much, and provides the necessary pockets and bushings and parts to attach the necessary accessories to. In addition to that, you would want a riser that looks good for you. The compound bow's early risers, wood, plastic, or molded in grips, were so massive they filled even large hands. Those big grips also created hand torque all too often. Competitive archers quickly recognized this problem and removed or filed down those grips. Today's slim grip combat, very goodly torque. The riser is that part of the bow you hold with your bow hand. Attached to it is the launcher with the arrow wrist or blade. The bow's limbs are attached to either ends of the riser. It is also the part where the stabilizer and weave bars connect and where the dampeners and sights connect. Risers are designed to be as rigid as possible. The central riser of a compound bow is usually made of aluminium, magnesium alloy, or carbon fiber, and many are made of 70-75 aluminium alloy. High-end compound bows today use carbon fibers to decrease the overall weight of the bow. Now let's see riser designs. There are three common riser designs: reflex, deflex, and straight. A reflex riser curves rearward with a grip set behind the limb pockets. The deflex riser curves forward with a grip ahead of the limb pockets. The grip is further from the string than the limb pockets are. As the name implies, the straight riser is straight with the grip and the pockets in line, parallel with the string. Well, you guys must be able to have an idea about what a reflex, deflex, and a straight riser is. The reflex riser is the most widely available. This design typically offers a very balanced feel with good arrow velocities due to the lower brace heights associated with them. The reflex design is more susceptible to problems with hand torque and is considered to be less forgiving than the other two designs. The reflex design is available on high-end bows, but may be difficult to find in less expensive models. This design is less popular due to its lower speed that results from higher than average brace height. This shape is less susceptible to the effects of hand torque. The brace heights and shape of this design make it the most forgiving design of the three. The straight riser is of course the average of the other two designs. This is true not only for the shape, but also the features and benefits of the shape. Very few bows are marketed with a perfectly straight riser. As indicated earlier, the riser design plays a part in the brace height of the bow. Brace height is the distance between the throat of the grip and the string when the bow is in the braced position, that is, not drawn. A lower brace height extends the power stroke of the bow by pushing forward on the arrow than a higher brace height. By pushing on the arrow for a longer period, more energy, more speed is imparted on the arrow. The increase in speed may be an advantage, However, the increased amount of time that the arrow spends on the string means that there is more time for the archer to make an error, or more time for errors to affect the arrow. Bows used for target archery generally have a minimum of 7 inches of brace height. Most target bows' brace height falls between 7 1/2 inch and 9 inches. There are several kinds of interchangeable grips that can be screwed onto the riser to change the angle of the grip. Latest bow risers. We can go on and on about the hundreds of models of risers, but today let's review some of the latest risers from the top brands in the market. The Hoyt Invicta is one of the latest and most popular target compound bows in the market. The Invicta is built with Hoyt's longest, most stable riser platform they have ever engineered. With a 2.5-inch increase in riser length, the Invicta is engineered with a lower center of mass and greater moment of inertia for the most effective aiming and rock-solid hold of any target bow Hoyt has ever built. What you're seeing is the world's most popular bow today, the Hoyt Invicta. The unique and proven shoot-through design incorporated in the Invicta riser noticeably increases lateral stiffness, resulting in a more consistent reaction of the bow as the arrow is released. It's also engineered for optimized balance, making the bow easier to aim than traditional open-shelf bows for ultimate accuracy, more perfect scores, and more podium finishes. The Invicta features an updated grip system for improved comfort, flexibility, and accuracy. The standard grip angle has been flattened for more optimized grip pressure and features an innovative, patent-pending, modular grip system that comes standard with each Invicta bow. The system allows for two different kinds of adjustment. First, you can change the angle of the grip, choosing between the flattened angle of 0 degrees and then +4 degrees for a medium wrist angle, or +8 degrees for an even higher wrist angle. Once you have dialed in your preferred grip angle, you then have additional grip modules to match each angle, but that shortens your draw length by 1/8 of an inch. Those archers looking to slightly shorten their draw length when going from indoor to outdoor, or looking for that final adjustment to find that perfect spot, can now do so with a simple change of grip without changing your tune or your sight marks. Talking about the linen pockets of the riser, the Invicta's zero tolerance pocket houses Hoyt's all new high performance parallel target limb system, making for the quietest and smoothest shot experience of any target bow Hoyt has ever built. In fact, the Invicta has nearly 50% less vibration and noise, making for a shooting experience like no other. Now let's quickly check out another popular riser from Matthews Archery in the latest model, TRX-34. The TRX-34 is the perfect crossover riser with a 6.5 inch brace height. The wider riser adds rigidity throughout the sight and rest mounting location, while the dovetail mount accommodates quads, IMX, and a new TRI rest. This new riser design also features 3D damping to reduce post-shot vibration. Now, enlarged diameter stabilizer bushing on the riser also increase stiffness of shooter stabilizer setup, enhancing accuracy. Now, let's check the latest release riser from PSC Archery's bow, announced as the Legend Reborn. For the 2021 Citation, PSC has delivered the stiffest reflex riser even in a new shoot-through design. PSC also engineered this bow with wide limb pockets for more adjustable cam spacing and perfect tuning. To further increase rigidity, the limb pockets on the new Citation utilize an updated riser lock design, and they have installed a new stainless steel cable rod to make this their most consistent target platform ever. The risers have a brace height of 7 3/4 of an inch in the Citation SS model, axle to axle 40 inches brow, and brace height of 7 1/4 of an inch in the Citation EM model, axle to axle 40 inches. Well, finally, now let's look into the Legend 730 model from Martin's Archery. The Legend 730 Jeff Hopkins Signature Series compound bow has the most advanced bow riser Martin ever created, with thousands of hours of R&D, research and design. This bow is unleashing its potential as a true winner thanks to inspiration from 10X SOY world champion Jeff Hopkins. This shoot-through riser helps keep flex to zero and accuracy on point. Legend 730 also features the RR80 weight distribution system in the riser that is fully adjustable to the archer's feet. This shoot-through bridged riser is the strongest riser ever created. Martin says with pride that this is the best target riser ever designed. Well, so much so for your knowledge on risers. In today's class, we learned about the most important part of the bow, which is the bow riser. I'll catch you soon with another session and another lesson. Well, you must go through this video several times if you want to be prepared. You may also plug in your headphones and listen to the audio daily during your traveling or other breaks of the day. Well, bye-bye. This is Shihan Hussaini. Catch you soon.